now, cooking with Chef Valkyrie.
Are you hungry for Italian? How about American?
Well then, my friends, you've come to the right place, because we're cooking up something special,
specifically for Valkyrie's attack.
And if you have problems with my cooking, then this vid is not for you. Now come along, join us as we use Valkyrie in a dish you won't forget.
Hello and welcome to Cooking with Valkyrie. This is my show. welcome. So, you want to cook with Valkyrie? Well, not anyone can do this. And if you are able to pull this off, you will need patience with the few ingredients that I have for you. So if you don't like tasty dishes, then this is not for you. Everybody else, get your cooking hat on, cause here we go. Step 1. When using Valkyrie against clan castles, make sure you pull the troops all the way to the corners so that you don't have to deal with unwanted firepower from the enemy weapons. Putting your Valkyrie in the sight of enemy weapons would mean she would be taken down faster, ruining your attack and the whole ingredients. So just do it, bring all the enemy clan castle troops to the end of the corner so that you are out of harm's way. Now how do you pull those clan castle troops? Well, that's simple. Use the hog riders. Hog riders are really good at getting in close to walls and jumping over them even to get to the weapons where they can actually pull those clan castle troops. Now you may not need to use hogs, you can actually use wall breakers or even barbarians if you bring more. But again, this is just a way to pull the clan castle troops. Now, step number 2. If you want to make sure this is a tasty dish, you have to gather all the troops together into one spot. And this is more than true for wizards, as they will be the ones to ruin the whole ingredients and you'll end up quitting before you even get started. So make sure you gather up all those troops. Step number 3. Once we got them to the corner, we're gonna need at least one barbarian or an archer to distract them. I would prefer a barbarian because they have more hit points on them and they're harder to take down than archers. By doing so, what you're doing is creating a diversion for your Valkyrie to get in there and take out the ranged weapon troops. If you just put them in there without creating a diversion, your Valkyrie will flinch most likely because she will be targeted and won't know what to do. Trust me, create a diversion. Unless you want to create your own ingredients, which is fine, but this is my way. Step number 4. Put Valkyrie next to the strongest enemies in the clan castle. In this case, which would be the wizards. The reason being, you want Valkyrie to attack as soon as she is placed on the field. Because if she has to run to her target, she most likely will be taken out before she can even swing her axe. So make sure you place her right next to the enemies that are strongest in the enemy clan castle. This is an example of what happens when you don't. Now as you can see, she swings and misses. Now sometimes this will happen in their favor and she won't even hit them at all. So just make sure you put them next to the wizards and make sure you do it right the first time. So we put all the ingredients in, everything looks good, and it's coming out just great. So now the only thing left to do is, once everything's in place and you put your Valkyrie down there, you just gotta call it out for what it is. Tell them what kind of dish you made. I like to say, spaghetti! Sometimes even, cheeseburger! Whatever it is, have fun with it, because in my opinion, it's better than using lightning spells and your own clan castle to stop theirs. And there you have it. So that just about wraps it up for our cooking lesson with Valkyrie. If you follow these simple steps, you too can be cooking like a Valkyrie. Hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to check me out and subscribe for more cooking lessons. This is Godson. I will see you guys next time. Godson out.